Hi, I'm Sune of the Raveonetttes. I'm in Genville.
When you are at home, but you haven't been home much, I guess. But when you are at home, you don't have a home. Okay, well, if you had a home with your very own kitchen, what would you cook?
Well, it would depend on where I was, depend on where my home is. If it was in Denmark, I'd probably do some open sandwiches, which is called smørrebrød in Danish, which is nice.
And what goes on those?
Well, it's like dark bread. You don't have it here. It's like a special kind of dark bread. And you have all kinds of, you can put meat on there, like ham if you like, and all kinds of, and then you put all kinds of like cucumbers, bean sprouts, all kinds of stuff. It's like, so it just gets bigger and bigger, right? And or very popular, you know, around Christmas time is if you eat the herring, all kinds of different herring, marinated herring, curry herring, all kinds of stuff.
Do you do it in like a cream sauce as well?
Or? No,
that's a different.
No, it's very
like a smoked or
yeah, it's very
vinegar.
Fishy kind of thing. Yeah, it's very because then you have to drink you drink beer with that and you drink the schnapps because the schnapps takes some of the. I don't know, the acidity of the fish or whatever.
Now, is that only at Christmas time? I thought that like smoked fish and fish is popular in that part of the world.
No, I mean it's the herring is mostly popular around Christmas. Yeah, when you go to a Christmas lunch, which is a tradition in Denmark, and you have start out with herring, all different kinds of maybe 8 different kinds, and then you move on to the other stuff. Could be ham or some sort of meatballs kind of thing or. But it's all on the dark bread. That's the whole trick.
Oh, so the herring goes on the dark bread too.
Yeah,
you make
yeah.
the open sandwich.
Oh, everything goes on the dark bread. Yeah.
That sounds good.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, it is good.
Is there anything that when you know you're coming to the States that you look forward to having that you can get here that you just don't get at home?
Well, of course the cheeseburgers taste better here than they do at home, and we eat quite a lot of those.
Do you have a special recipe in mind?
I have a pasta kind of thing that I usually do, but it's only in the summertime because it's like very fresh. It's not really a wintery kind of thing. And you don't want me to just tell how
yeah,
I do
just
it?
Tell me about, yeah,
oh yeah,
tell
yeah,
me about
yeah.
It.
Well, you know what I do is it's very simple. I just get a lot of fresh tomatoes, and I chop them up, finely chop them up, and I put them in a big bowl, and then I add I chop up garlic as much as you like, depends on how much you like garlic, and very finely chopped, and you chop up onion, very finely chopped also, and you get a lot of basil and maybe some parsley. Salt and pepper, and you mix it all in a bowl, and you leave it there for. Again, it depends on how strong you want it with the garlic or whatever, you know. But I usually leave it there for like 6 to 8 hours.
Oh wow!
And then it's really tasty. And then you cook pasta, and you serve the pasta, and you serve it with the cold. You never cook or the sauce or anything.
You just
it's
put
like
the heat
it's raw.
Of the pasta.
Yeah, like just heat the pasta and then put this cold thing on top of it. And I like that because it's cheap and it's easy to make. And get a big old bottle of Cabernet Sauvignon.
Perfect.
Yeah.
Well, you sound like you know what you're doing.
I love to cook. I need a home.
You do need a home.
That's what I keep telling myself. Yeah.
Well, you've been touring for what, 14 months straight or something?
Yeah,
like
exactly.
That? Yeah, that's a long time.
Yeah, it is.
When will you get back?
That's the problem. I don't get back to where. I don't have a home, so that's really the issue, you know.
Will you pick a home in Denmark, or do you think you're...
No, I won't do that. No.
Try the States for a while? Or?
Well, you know, there's a lot of issues to deal with. Visas and all kinds of stuff. It's very difficult to be a Danish touring band, because there's a lot of issues, believe me.
Oh, really?
Yeah. That's the thing.
Well, it's really been a pleasure talking with you about food.
Yeah, yeah.
You made me hungry.
Oh, well, I'm hungry now.
Thank you very much,
Thank you.
Really nice to talk with you.
Thanks.